Hey, you made it. Great to see you. Oh, who am I? My name is Mojak Lehoko, and you're watching Stuff Your Holiday Food and Stuff You. And yes, you've guessed it. Today we're going to talk about holiday foods. Nom, 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 nom. Ooh, leftovers. This used to taste like chicken. But before we do that, please don't forget to subscribe to make sure you get more sizzling takes on many more important subjects, including whether an old man climbing down your chimney is a little, triggering. Santa can't go to the hood, he'll end up on the news. Yay! So, the holidays. What better way to spend them than by eating enough of your favorite food to make you start hating it? I never want to see a trifle again. For the first time ever, more people have a higher risk of dying from eating too much than from eating too little. The Red Cross estimates that worldwide, 1.5 billion people were dangerously overweight last year, while 925 million were underfed. Must be nice, said the 925, as they scroll down your Instagram feed to see food. Oh, look at them, they are so well-fed in the West. I haven't eaten since July. Hashtag must be nice. In any case, if overeating was a stock, then my dear friends, now is the time to buy the shit out of it. Because that time of the year when we all start consuming industrial quantities of food is here again. From the pickled herring dishes of Sweden, which look as devoid of taste as the Swedes do, of melanin. Sorry, Sweden. I know you're all using SPF 5000, but it's not our fault. Look here, no sunscreen. To the crispy looking lechon or roasted pig of Puerto Rico. Puerto Rico, more like Porco Rico. Because it's pork. These are great jokes, guys. In Greenland, they're gorging down on matik, which is literally strips of whale blubber and wait, what? Reindeer meat. Wait, no. Guys, who thought this was a decent combo? Fish and chips. Yes. Pop and flace. Whale blubber and reindeer meat. Get together. But yes, nothing brings you and your wife together quite like free willy cellulite tastefully arranged around Rudolph the well-smoked reindeer. Rudolph the well-smoked reindeer is also his name when he's had a fat blunt.
So last year we were flying over the North Pole and like, man, it's far, bro.
Santa. Closer to home, here on the African continent, we're going to open our mouths wide and say, ah, for a spoonful of gammon, or bride meat, or malva pudding. That's right, down here in South Africa, we're appropriating all the foods in the name of Christmas. We're having pasta, we're having tacos, we're having turkeys, we're having fish and chips. These foods are not from here, guys. Now you are in Soweto eating chow mein. How misplaced of a dish. You think somewhere in the UK, somebody's eating sausages?
Exactly.
South Africans, you like things. It's the only time of year where we order turkeys. Turkeys? What are turkeys even doing in Africa? It's not their natural environment. I mean, our turkeys need sunscreen. They're getting sunburnt out here just waiting to be put in the oven. We don't have to cook our turkeys. We just leave them in the sun. Yes, they'll still be raw, but they'll look like they are ready to eat. And we really pack it on for Christmas too, rendering our summer bodies obsolete after one sitting. And best believe, the waste is real. Get it? Because we're wasting the food and then our waste. I can do better. I know I can. The situation is not that different around the world. More than 1.3 billion tons of food are thrown away every year. And speaking of waste, let's take a look at Wigilia, the name of Polish and Ukrainian Christmas festivities where 12 separate dishes are served representing the 12 apostles of Jesus. Well, Jesus Christ indeed, because with 12 separate dishes tumbling down your gut, you're going to need the whole family to help you Wigilia out of your pants. Wigilia. Wiggly, huh? Wiggle, wiggle. Okay, let me be honest. The only reason why I put up with my family over the holidays is because I don't have to cook, and I'm sure it's the same for you. It's just the easiest way for us, lazy, hungry idiots of the world, to get our hands on all those culinary masterpieces, such as halakas from Venezuela, smahalov, a whole steamy sheep's head from Norway, or, as we call it, skorpo, which I assume is derived from the Afrikaans word for sheep, skap. Who knew South Africans and Norwegians had skorpo in common? I didn't. No way. You see? And also, hooves. I can see myself with hooves, just hooving them down. I might need to book a flight to Norway next Christmas. I mean, after lockdown, of course. There's also codfish and boiled potatoes from Portugal. Ah, and don't forget, foie gras from France. You don't want to know how that's made, but I'm going to tell you, because I have no sense of boundaries. It gets made by force feeding a goose until it gets really obese. So it's probably safe to say that you're going to foie gras yourself this Christmas. Too soon? But look at yourself. Anyway, in 2020, 2011, a ragtag team of chocolate makers in Italy had a dream, and that dream was to give everyone diabetes.
I have a dream that one day everyone will eat chocolate.
That was a speech Martin Luther didn't get to make. R.I.P. He was about to liberate chocolate. To liberate chocolate people. Guys, open your third eye. They wanted to make sure that even affordable chocolate could cost you an arm and a leg. Get it? Because when you have diabetes, you're walking to Christmas. The legs are gone. Also, they wanted to build the largest chocolate Santa in the world. But people laughed when they heard this dream. They said, you can't build that. But this dream team of chocolatiers wanted to live their best life. So they replied, Cantu, which coincidentally is also the name of the city where this monstrosity was built. Cantu, Italy. It's the part of Italy they don't show you on brochures. There's Naples, Milan, Rome, Cantu. No can do for me. Coming in at 5 meters and 1.88 tons, it took 6 people exactly 6 weeks to build it. And in the true spirit of Christmas, it was truly empty inside. Like your hopes and dreams after doing second year adversity for the third time. Just look at this amazing piece of culinary art. People, let's just accept it now already, right? Come Christmas Day, we're going to eat like shit. Everything. Look, don't beat yourself up about it. And don't even shame yourself the following morning. We've all tortured ourselves with those hateful questions. Why did I stab the dumpling bread with chicken feet and dip it into the milk tart? And why do I treat gravy like it's salad dressing? It's because on Christmas Day, chicken feet are a fork and gravy is the salad dressing. Guys, we've all had that meal. Here you're eating a roast lamb, a chicken foot, dipping it in the trifle while breaking those quality street chocolates and having that choice assorted biscuits. But hey, if you want to be a superstar, why not give up feasting altogether? Do that intermittent fasting thing like you always wanted to. Save the planet and destroy your family's Christmas dinner by judging everyone else with your newfound moral superiority. Oh, you're having more starch, Granny. You'll never find a man. Because let's face it, nothing says happy holidays, fam, quite like the sentence, I'm doing intermittent vegan fasting at the dinner table. Like a fucking boss. Thanks for watching, and remember, Jesus didn't have a YouTube account, but if he did, he'd definitely have commented on this video. Thank you, Jesus. Hey, peeps, did you guys like what you watched? If you did, then click over here or here. It's what Jesus would have wanted. Him and I spoke last night.